Hi friends, welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, I'm going to share some of my learnings, things that I wish I knew when I started my data science career journey. For those of you who know, who are familiar with my career journey, I'm actually a self-taught data scientist. I did not go to a school and study data science. So a lot of things I had to learn while doing the job. And this is a video that I wish I had seen when I was starting out in data science, so I thought it'd be a good idea for me to talk about this topic and share some of my learnings. So for those of you who are new to data science, you don't make those mistakes. Before we jump into the video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more about data science, career, tech lifestyle, and everything else in between. Let's jump right into it. One of the biggest learnings for me has been is, number one is don't try to learn everything. As I have talked about it in some of my other videos, and I'm gonna link some of them somewhere here, data science is a huge domain. So when you are just starting out, it's very easy to get lost. Let's say if you are like data analyst or data scientist, whatever you're trying to do, like it's a very huge domain. So it's very easy to get lost in it. A perfectionist, somebody like me who would wanna learn every single thing that is part of the data job family, I learned it the hard way that I actually didn't need to learn everything. So my advice for anybody who is new is try not to learn everything. Create a backward plan. For example, if you are a student and you're trying to figure out what you should learn, I would say like figure out what you want to do. If you have an ideal role, an ideal company in mind, study that, create a plan, work backward, and then focus on the things that you have figured out that are important for your ideal role. So that helps you narrow down in terms of what you need to learn. The second biggest learning for me was, and this is an interesting one, I don't think we talk about it enough, understanding that not all of my work is going to get productionized. Let me say that again. Understanding that not all of my work is going to get productionized. This is something that I learned in my last company where I would work on a lot of research projects, assuming that once I finish that project, the business team is actually going to take that project and implement it. To my surprise, that was actually not the case. A lot of the times, the project wouldn't get productionized. So let's say if I worked on like 5 projects, only 2 or 3 of them would get productionized. And it is kind of like discouraging when you work on something super cool that you think is amazing, it doesn't get implemented. I want to say that it's actually okay. Like a lot of the data science work is research focused. So when you're talking about research, in research, not everything makes it. So just having that mindset, just understanding that it's great that you worked on something, but possible that it might not get implemented. One way to avoid that is like you start working backward with a business problem, with a business objective, and then work backward and then solve a problem. So that's like one way to avoid this problem. I have realized like the projects where I worked with the problem first approach, those do end up getting more traction when it comes down to implementation and productionization of the project. So that was my number 2 tip. Number 3, I would say is, and this is not specific to data science, I would say like this can get applied to any role, is advocate for yourself. Building something, doing something, working on a data science project, working on a super cool project, it's great, but you have to be able to advocate for yourself and for your work. I've learned that doing the work is actually half of the work. Advocating for your work is actually even more important. Not just for like getting your project productionized, but also like when it comes down to performance reviews, career development, promotions, and all those ratings and all those sort of things. Advocating for your work and highlighting how exactly your work helped the business, it's key. So for example, let's take 2 people. One person, both of them worked on a really cool project. One person took that project, like wrote a 1 paragraph on it, highlighting how their project has helped the business team, and they share it. Now they are advocating their work, and the people who are reading those paragraphs, if let's say that person is sending an email or whatever, all those people are now gonna advocate for your work. So you have to do that to be able to showcase your work. So going back to the example, person A also worked on a cool project, but they didn't advocate for their work. they didn't quantify their impact, who's going to have a better rating when it comes down to performance review? Who's going to have a better review? So doing the work is important, but also highlighting the work, quantifying the impact is even more important. And my last tip and bonus tip, which is basically for anybody, don't stay at a company or team or a specific product focus area for too long. There are a few reasons I'm saying that. One is financially, when you switch jobs, when you switch companies, logically your compensation increases. Obviously, like you get through those like performance reviews and stuff and you get some bump, but it's never going to be equivalent of what you would get if you were to switch a company. So financially, it does make sense to switch around. This is how much the corporate America is designed. The second is, and I think that's even more important, is the learning aspect. When you switch teams, when you get introduced to new business domains, new product domains, new focus areas, new data sets, you get to learn along that process. And switching teams can help you get to that. If you are like working at a big company where you have the option to switch team, you can switch teams and get exposed to their business domain, their product domain, and different type of data sets and different type of problems that you'll be solving. And that's going to give you the breadth, which is very important, especially if we're talking about a data science role or even a data analyst role. On the same note, switching companies gives you exposure to different working environment, different cultures, especially if you're new. When I was at my previous company, I loved everything they did. And to me, that was my ideal because I hadn't seen anything better. But after leaving that company and working for another big tech company, I'm realizing that there are a lot of things that I see different. And there are a lot of things that I actually enjoy in a company culture that I didn't have at my last company. So if you are new, like I highly recommend to like switch around. And whether that you change a team, whether that you change a company, because it's actually going to expose you to different work culture, different learning style, different data sets, different work environment, and financially, it makes sense to move around. I think we're gonna do a different video on this where we're gonna talk about the comp structure, especially in big tech where RSU is a big component. And when I do that video, it'll all make sense to you, like why moving around is actually more beneficial than sticking around. All right, that's all I wanted to say. Let me know if any of this resonates with you. Let me know in the comments if there are additional learnings that you would like to share with everybody. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a beautiful day and I'll see you in another video. Bye.